some situations that's not going to change. But I just want you to know that His grace is sufficient.
Yes, Jesus.
Paul went on to do even greater things after he had the encounter with God. Paul, he wanted to get the relief. But God said, I want to use a marred vessel for my glory.
Yes, Jesus.
So he left the infirmity there.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I want to say something about a man or woman that has a limp in their life.
Yes, Jesus. Yes, Jesus.
A man or woman that has a limp in their life.
Yes, Jesus.
Something about
yes, Jesus.
There's something about it. There's a level of brokenness.
Yes, Jesus.
There's a level of brokenness.
Oh, God, I thank you.
There's a level of brokenness. That makes them keep coming after God.
Yeah.
Since the level of brokenness and some things that in my life Jesus. God has broken me in tremendously. That keeps me coming after Him. That yeah. keeps me up 3-4 hours sometime on the weekend praying. Yeah. Talking to God, laboring yeah. to get a word from Him.
Yeah.
To get to this place where I am.
Yeah.
That I don't worry about the what's in life. That I understand that I'm a revelation.
Yeah.
It's something about
thank you,
the lips. That's in my life.
Yeah.
Every man, woman of God, that's truly been used by God, has a limp.
Yeah.
Whether it's physical, whether it's spiritual, there's something in their life that God hasn't removed.
Yes,
He said, I'm not going to remove it, but I'm going to leave it there. It's that thing that keeps you coming after me. See, it's that thing that keeps me meeting God.
Yes, Jesus.
It's that thing that keeps me knowing I can have the testimony. They say, no one stands with me.
Yes,
no
yes.
one was in the dungeon with me but God.
Yes, Jesus.
But God.
Yes. Yeah, Lord.
In that dungeon, that place of loneliness and despair.
Yes.
If you stop, you're going through.
Yes.
I can recall being in a place like that myself.
Yes.
No one stood with me. No one to talk to me. But something happened. Something happened.
Yeah.
And my attitude changed. My situation had changed. I still wasn't changed.
Yeah, yeah.
But something happened.
Yeah, Jesus.
Something happened. My attitude changed.
Yes, Jesus.
That was a new strength.
Yes,
Jesus. That was a new strength.
Yes,
oh, no, He didn't deliver me.
Yeah.
He didn't deliver me at that time. I had to stay there.
Yeah.
My attitude changed.
Yes, Jesus.
And when my attitude changed, I could be like Paul. I was praying for others on the outside.
Yeah.
I had people come to visit me and said, you pray for me. The people that are supposed to come minister to us, we were ministering to them.
Yes, Jesus.
And we were in chains.
Yeah.
You know, my situation didn't change from none of that. I stayed even longer. I think I'd do 5 more years of turnaround. But something happened.
Yes, Jesus.
I learned about the renewed strength of God.
Yes, Jesus.
Son, I'm not going to set you free.
Yes.
But I'm going to give you strength for the journey.
Yes, Jesus.
He's going to give somebody
yes,
strength for the journey.
Yes,
it's not going to end tomorrow. It's not going to end today. But I'm going to give you strength for the journey. Advise you to pray. That God would meet you in that place. And that he would renew your strength.
Yes, Jesus.
And pray that you would die daily to your flesh.
Yes, Jesus.
Die daily to your flesh.
Yes, Jesus.
You have to do that daily. You have to die. Ask God for a praying spirit.
Yes, Jesus.
It's good for people to pray over you, pray for you, pray with you. But when you can go to him for yourself,
yes, Jesus.
It's not like that.
Yes, Jesus.
It's nothing like going to God for yourself.
Yes, Jesus.
You know, because when you go for yourself, you get a clear cut answer. You get a clear cut answer when you go for yourself.
Yes, Jesus.
I learned how to go to him for myself.
Yes.
And he deals with me.
Yes.
He deals with me deep. Because there's a level of brokenness I told you that I preach and I teach from. It's not like most other folk. It's that limp. It's that thing in my life.
Yes, yes.
So you can't tell everybody you're limp. They might trip you up.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I know I got a limp. You got one too.
Yes, 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 Jesus.
Yeah, it's that limp.
Yeah.
That keeps me.
Uh-huh.
He said, I'm not going to take it away. But you're going to serve me right on. And I'm going to get the glory out of your life.
Yes, Jesus.
And as long as he gets the glory, I'm all right.
Yes.
I'm all right. I'm taking it.
Yes, Jesus. Yes, Jesus.
He's kept me almost 50 years with the limp.
Yes, Jesus.
I already deal with it.
Yes.
And he may get the glory.
Yes, thank you.
Oh, yeah, I'm all right.
Yeah.
I'm going to Nero's Market.
Yes.
I'm going to lay my life down because I fought a good fight.
Yes.
I fought a good fight.
Jesus.
I finished the course.
Yes.
And I know there's something greater laid up
yes,
for you.
Jesus.
And so you can have that type of faith.
Yes, glory. Jesus.
When you're looking at death doors.
Jesus.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God.
Oh, yes,
said,
Lord.
There's something greater laid up for me. I'm going to
yes,
put
Lord.
This down here.
Jesus.
Because you only can kill his body one time anyway.
Yes,
you only can kill it one time.
Yes, Lord.
But I know the one that can raise it back up.
Oh, yes, Lord.
I know the one that can raise it back up.
Yes, Jesus.
And that's all that matters.
Jesus.
At the end of the day, that's all that matters. The one
yes.
that's raising it.
Yes,
so just know, in your extremities, when you run out of what you're able to do, that's when renewed strength kick in.
Yes, Jesus.
Sometimes we need renewed strength
yes.
to deal with a sickly loved one.
Yes.
Somebody need that today. God, give them the strength.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus, God, give them the strength
yes, Lord.
To deal